this next topic comes from one of the people who commented on one of my videos. The YouTube user is Marc Landry, and he commented on my video on Kwonmunism, Hour of Kwonmunism number 2. And so I'll read his comment here, or just kind of paraphrase it, I guess. I don't want to read the whole thing. But he said he was, I'm assuming it's a he because it's Marc Landry. That name sounds like a male name. If you're not a male guy, definitely let me know, but I'm assuming you're a guy. But he says that he was curious about my views on volunteerism or charity abroad versus volunteering here in the United States. And that's because he also, you know, he found volunteerism outside the United States really rewarding. And he is thinking about this because he read from like a lot of angry bloggers that complain about celebrities that help organizations outside their home country. But he thinks that the United States no way compares to others in terms of issues like famine, HIV, sexism, etc. And so he wanted me to talk about this topic in this video, and then that's what I'm doing. So, oh, that's a side note too. If any of you guys are out there watching any of my videos and think, hey, this is something that David Kwon should talk about, or I would find it interesting if he talked about this, and I would like to learn his thoughts about this, and share my thoughts as well. If you want to have a discussion in like the YouTube comment section, which I end up becoming far too involved in sometimes, when I feel like sometimes I should just kind of let it go, just kind of comment what I have to say, and then just leave it. But it's hard because I do like discussions. But anyway, if you would like me to talk about a topic that you think is interesting, definitely shoot me a comment. You can PM me, message me, and maybe if I find it a good topic and interesting enough for me to talk about, I'll talk about it in one of my next videos in the future. Who knows? But anyway, back to this topic at hand about volunteering or charity overseas. I definitely think international charity is really important because it is a good point that United States, a country like United States or advanced industrialized nation in Europe or in Asia, countries like Japan, Singapore, South Korea, Great Britain, United Kingdom, Germany, France, what have you. I mean, they all have, every country has its issues. But, I mean, simple matter of fact is you compare the issues that are plaguing America compared to issues that are plaguing Uganda or Rwanda or Ethiopia. Obviously, countries like Ethiopia, Uganda, Rwanda have it much worse. You know, they have war wars there. They have civil wars going on there. In America, yesterday, a bomb blew off in Boston, and that was like one of the first times that ever, well, it has happened. There has been like Oklahoma City bombings and such, but it's like, it's a whole different world where, you know, the other countries, it's a daily reality, whereas in America, something like that happens, and it's a big news for that one whole year or even for like a decade or so. You know, so obviously the point is, yes, other countries do need volunteerism more. So it is definitely like something like if you're comparing on a need basis, I do agree. You know, charity, international charity is really important, and it's like Marc Landry says, it's definitely really rewarding. I do, me personally, I do plan sometime in my life I want to join the Peace Corps because I want to go to another country and kind of learn what's going on in the other country, but also to help the other country because, like, I guess if you just compare it, although I don't really recommend comparing it in this manner, but, you know, it's inevitable that your mind does this, but if you're just comparing it like that, you know, it's the other countries need more help. They're in much worse shape, in a way, so to speak, which is, I don't want to sound condescending to other countries or anything like that, but that's just the kind of the thoughts that happen with people, you know, in a country like America or United Kingdom or France or what have you. But at the same time, me personally, after I do, you know, some years of Peace Corps, whenever that happens, I'm going to be going back to America, and I would rather, me personally, I would rather devote my life to charity, domestic charity, and not international charity. And there are some reasons behind that. That's not to downplay international charity. I just think international charity is fraught with more danger than there is controversy, but I think the controversy that all of these angry bloggers that you mentioned, Marc Landry, are not, their criticisms of celebrities going to another country and, doing that, that's not what I'm too concerned, that's not what I'm more concerned about. I mean, what those angry bloggers are concerned is that it has a very condescending attitude. You know, it's just like, oh, you know, look at these people living in these countries, they're doing so awful, we're helping them do this, and it's like a PR marketing spin that celebrities go there and do that. That's kind of the issue that these angry bloggers have, in my opinion. I don't know, maybe they have the other issues, but my concern is, to me, when it comes, like, I feel like when we go to different countries and volunteer, we do it without learning too much about what's happening in the other countries. So there is much more danger of doing more harm or imposing our will on the people of other cultures and other countries more than actually helping them become better, like help them become more independent and help their society grow and become more prosperous. There is more of that danger. Certainly that there's that danger also in domestic charity, definitely. But I think the difference in domestic charity is that we are very familiar with this environment. We know our environments well, and there's, especially, well, I'm in New York City, so I'm biased here, but a lot of non-charities in New York City are grassroots-based. They start from people who are suffering from this issue. For example, I'm currently volunteering at HousingWorks, which is a nonprofit organization that serves the needs of people who are living with HIV and AIDS and are homeless or in need of housing assistance. This organization, HousingWorks, was founded by a person living with HIV and AIDS and homeless person. It's a grassroots organization. The person who had this issue was the one who founded this issue in this local community. The problem with international charity is it's a foreigner coming into this environment and saying, this is what I want to do, and this is how we're starting it. And that person, it's not a grassroots nonprofit. Nonprofit doesn't have to be grassroots, but in my opinion, it's one of the most effective way for a nonprofit to be. Because that when a nonprofit is grassroots, it understands the needs of that community. It understands it. It fosters communications well. The community understands the grassroots organization. So there is a great deal of the communication there, great understanding. There is less chance of malpractice, so to say. And malpractice is a weird term to use. I want to use a better term for that. But like misabuse, unintentional misabuse. You know, people go into other countries with great intentions. One example I'm going to mention is the Rwanda genocide crisis. So in Rwanda, there was this mass genocide between the Tutsis and the Tutus, if I remember correctly. Man, I want to check my notes on this, but I, you know what, let me just talk. Maybe I'm wrong. You can fact check me on the YouTube comments if I'm wrong. But it was on the Tutsis and Tutus. I can't remember which group. See, this is what I'm saying. Like, a foreigner going into a country, we have to do so much research. We don't go there like completely well aware of what's going on. That's the danger. You know, we have to go into it fully well researched so that what we're doing doesn't do harm, even if we go in there with great intentions, because that's what happened in Rwanda. What happened in Rwanda was there was this genocide. About 8 million people or amazing amount of people, not amazing, bad word, ridiculous amount of people, were massacred with machetes, and it was a total genocide. And by the time that international communities like Red Cross and UN stepped in, most of the genocide was already over. And so when these humanitarian organizations stepped into this country, what ended up happening was there was a civil war before these humanitarian organizations came in. And the civil war was because, okay, I'm kind of telling the story really badly. Okay, so let's go back, sorry. I'm not eloquent. I'm really sorry about that. But there is this genocide. One group, a small minority group, mass murders the majority group. And about more than 8 million people are murdered in this genocide and displaced. And a lot of them find refuge in neighboring countries like Uganda, like other countries, right? And in these countries, there are refugees. But in these other countries, they develop armed forces. Other people in this country decide these people need help because they're African people, African countries. They find like people's militias. These militias come back to their home country and fight a civil war. Okay, so these people were genocided against. The victims come back as soldiers. There's a civil war, and the people who committed the genocide are driven out. That happened. It's after that happened that humanitarian organizations came in, not knowing the full story of what happened, because they didn't have enough time to research. The whole time they were debating whether to go in or not in their countries with the politics and politicians, and we have these kinds of debates a lot in other countries. International organizations came in. What did they do? Ultimately, they helped the people who were driven out by the civil war. If we know the full story, the people who were driven out at that point were the people who started out the genocide. See, great intentions here, but you were helping the wrong people. Not only that, UN people came in and they started killing dogs. And they started, it was great amount of people were helped, but we helped the wrong kind of people. And the same kind of stigma reached across Rwanda was a total mess. And that's possible because sometimes humanitarian organizations go into another country without knowing the full story, without being able to know the full story. Because people in power at the time, before the Civil War, were people who committed the genocide. They were the ones calling out for help. Like, hey, we're having the Civil War. We're victims right now. We need international help. We need your help because we're being driven out of our country. They're being driven out because they were perpetrators of mass genocide. That Rwanda example is a really powerful example to me in that if we're not careful about how we're aiding other countries, how we're aiding foreign people who we're not really knowledgeable about, we're imposing our will on them as foreigners. And that's, as a social work major, one of the great values of social work is respect for autonomy of individuals, of communities. That's why grassroots nonprofit organization is really important. I really think ideally if I was to help in other parts of the world as a volunteer, I would love to go there as a follower of one of the leaders in that culture. I don't want to go there founding an organization and going to another country with that nonprofit. What I think would be ideal is going in, finding people who would be capable leaders in that community and fostering their leadership skills and helping that leader find other people in his own local community. And that local community develops its own nonprofit that starts in that country, not from a foreign country. And that nonprofit becomes what helps that community. The community should help itself, is my point. And this is a model that's a lot of the nonprofit organizations in New York City operate this way. A lot of them started in New York City. A lot of them started with people who have the same issues. You know, a substance abuse treatment center, the original founder was probably a drug addict. You know, it started because he was having problems. He got out of it. That's nonprofit. That's the grassroots nonprofit. Community building itself up. Doesn't necessarily have to be that way, but I think it's the most effective way. In domestic ways, I mean, I could start a nonprofit maybe as, you know, about prison reform. I've never been in prison myself. But if I went in there communicating with people and starting a nonprofit that way, it would be great. If I founded that similar organization here and went to a different country and expanded with this nonprofit and just kind of imposing it, I think that's a that has a big chance of being misabused. You know what I mean? And that's a danger that we don't realize until it's too late, just like Rwanda. People didn't realize it until 3 years after Red Cross went in, and then Red Cross people started realizing, holy crap, we are helping the wrong people. We are continuing the genocide in Rwanda. What do we do now? You know, I mean, they eventually had to shift the policy, and Rwanda ultimately, it's still a troubling, it's still a troubled place. Darfur is still one of the most troubled areas in the world. But after they realized that is when international charities finally actually started helping and not harming. There is a far greater chance of international charity harming rather than helping. In domestic charity, we are well aware of our surroundings. Of course, sometimes we go in without knowing too much. There are a lot of nonprofits that do abuse, that do get corrupt in domestic charity as well. But I'm just talking about chance and probability is far less likely. And that's why I really think the better effort should be spent when we're talking about overseas, not heading over to seas and helping out, but helping those overseas community develop their own ways of, you know, helping their own community. I think it's better to help them help themselves rather than going there and using our own, imposing our methods and our values on them. Because that's pretty much the definition of colonialism. And it's that's the danger there also, that overseas charity can become like another form of colonialism, and we definitely don't want that. So those are my thoughts on this topic. It's definitely a big topic, so definitely, you know, you can share more of your thoughts on this, and maybe in a future video, I can talk even more about this topic. It's a really interesting topic that you brought up. Thank you so much for, bringing this topic up. It's a great topic to talk about, especially for me as someone who graduated with a bachelor's in social work.